Now we're going to have a look at this dual band combiner. It is using 7/16 RF connectors. It is really big and heavy, so it can handle quite a lot of power. The two different GSM bands, so of course for two different antennas. And I'm betting this plug here is for moisture, so moisture can get out and water cannot go in. And for really good shielding to the tower against, you know, for lightning handling. So there's a funny thing here, is a DC feed through on these two ports, but not on this one. And if you take an ohm meter, I just did that, and measured, you have 0 ohms on DC on this input. And this one is of course open, and this one, the sensor pin here, is directly connected to the common, of course, for DC, but not for RF, right? I also tried to give this up to 30 volts. I didn't measure any current draw, and the voltage goes straight through. All right, so let's open this bad boy and see what's inside. Why is this? Ah, okay. Good, so they coated it or painted it or something for waterproofing. Let's have a look at this nice thing. So the DC feed through. So only one inductor and a few capacitors. And just a DC cable, and then it goes down to another inductor and a gas discharge, and then it goes over here. So another inductor and two capacitors. See the other one? This is the DC short. There's actually a little wire to ground. That is a little bit interesting. I can't wait to see how this is connected to the cavities. So this is made of copper. It's really heavy, or maybe it's just copper plated. It looks like the internal here is actually copper plated. This is very normal to have it aluminium and then nickel and then silver. I haven't seen it like this. Let's see if it's silvered inside. This is what I would expect for better performance. So I need to unscrew all these, so I'm better gonna go and get a machine for that. Whoa, copper screws, huh? That is nice. This is a little bit confusing. Some are actually Torx, those as well, and then here Phillips, and also copper. And this, some of these, two of them, they were also copper. So that is a little bit weird combination. Let's unscrew everything. Yeah, yeah. Nice copper. I guess they are just copper plated screws. Or maybe they're copper all the way through. We will see in a second what is inside. And we are in. Why? Something is wrong. Ugh. It feels a little bit springy. Oh. We got coils. So what we should have done, we should have desoldered these before I try to pull this up. Oh, bloody hell. I'll solder. Here we go. And those are most likely made of Teflon. Think we're in. Exactly. So it's copper. But this is not at all heavy. So we're talking about copper plated aluminium. And this is of course for low intermodulation and for low loss. Normally it's all silver. So I guess this is not the best when it comes to intermodulation, because they're combining materials. And what you see here, there will be all the different screws for resonance in the different cavities. And here is something fantastic. So this is the common that is connected to both the different sides. And see, there's both direct and indirect cavities. It's really fantastic. Also, this is called a cross coupling. There's a little bit of a capacity coupling in here. Normally, this can be moved. And then there's a screw here, so you can tighten it. See? Okay. I'm going to try and pull this up. These cross couplings makes in-phase and out-of-phase connections, so you can have much steeper filters. You normally do this on one of the sides, so that the isolation in between the two bands can be really, really high. I'll try and take a few of these up. Here we go. Let's look at the different resonators. I believe this is brass, something. It's quite heavy. Normally they are made of aluminum and then silver plated, but they can also be brass, and because it's easier to machine in brass. I've seen this a lot of time using brass and then silver plating. See, the height of the feeding is different in the two different bands. This is of course because they wanted to have different impedances. The closer you are to the bottom, the lower the feeding impedance will be. It's also something to do with the length and everything here. So it's a little bit complicated. And break this off, but quite nice. But this is how it works, and this is the cross coupling. It makes a cross coupling that is out of phase to make a steeper isolation. Let's try and pull this up so we can have a look. Ah, yes, exactly. You see, this is also very normal. There's a thread in each side, so you adjust this, put this up and down, and then you adjust this, and then you have exactly the right length, and then you put it in, and it is in a lock with a little screw from the top. Really, really nice. It looks simple, but it is really, really complicated to design those filters.